Tuesday, November 10th. Welcome aboard to this edition of Barnstable Today. I'm Kevin Friel.
And I'm Len Gobeil.
We'd like to remind you right at the top that the meetings we cover are available on demand at the town's website, www.town.barnstable.ma.us. Now, as the fall season is here, planning for next summer season is well underway. Earlier this week, the Sandy Neck Board met to determine what the fee schedule would be like for next season.
Final fee determination. Last week, well, last month, we talked about it, and subsequent to that, the numbers had been passed along to everyone as to, you know, what each of the other beaches are charging, and we did have one comment that they had hoped that we wouldn't go up on the fees. We take that into consideration, and I'd like to take and open it up to consideration for folks and what their thoughts are.
Fee increase will occur in the fourth year. We haven't had any fee increases in the last three, so it's on the fourth year we'll finally get fee increase.
That's correct, yeah.
Okay, yeah, so it's been a long time. And I know the economy is rough right now, but you know, I agree with you, Rich. I think that if we forewent another year without any increase in our fees and potential revenue, that we have the worry looking at a large increase in expenses as anticipated,
right,
that it wouldn't serve us well.
If we forego a rate increase this time around, that eventually we're going to have a bigger increase. My feeling is that we should take and do it incrementally so that it doesn't hurt a lot. And that's my real emphasis here, that I'd like to take and have a minimal increase so that we're not doing it as a sticker shock, if you will. So one of the issues that I thought would be appropriate is adding $5. All right. Currently, right now, the fee for a resident is $70. And I'd like to propose it for $75. Non-resident is $140. I'd like to kick that up to $145.
$150.
I'm sorry. It's that has to be
that's
a $10. Right.
$150.
And then the sandwich residents would go up the same amount. Really, that would be a $10 increase for the sandwich residents. And I believe it is justified. Ultimately, down the road, the sandwich residents will be utilize our facilities. And I think that with a long-term goal in mind, that we're going to end up having this fee increase will help us prepare to take and have a better
product.
Bath facility. A facility that we hope is going to end up being more than just a bath facility.
Kevin, the planning board met Monday night as well, and one of the items on their agenda was the discussion of adding medical use to the Hyannis office multifamily zoning district.
We have been requested to reexamine where medical and dental offices are allowed in town. It was based on the fact that we had a major project in the growth incentive zone come before us and ask basically for a special permit to negotiate the fact that they could put medical and dental services at 46 North Street. And a year ago, we had a request from a landlord who had made the same request that we review this zoning and consider reinstating, because it originally did allow medical and dental, and we consider reinstating. So what Joanne has here is the basic GIS map that shows where the zones are now, and she's also handed out verbiage with potential amendments to the OM district. On the top, what's in front of us here basically is if we did it by right, that would be in section A. There's some suggested language in red if it was by right, and if it was according to special permit, that would be in section B. And there's a couple of definitions there at the bottom of the page. So, Joanne?
Sure. After our last discussion, this is based on that, and so it offers these amendments to you in two forms, as Felicia's described. First of all, I wanted you to just take a look at the growth incentive zone map to see what we're talking about. Medical uses are allowed, of course, in the medical services district, and there are some, and we gave you that information. I think there's in the office and multifamily district, I think there's five existing uses that are medical. In addition to the 46 North Street that you just permitted a few weeks ago, which is already up and running, construction-wise. And so we had the discussion last time, how would this go forward? And of course, there's two ways. It can be a by right use, or you can choose to add it as a specially permitted use, and with whatever criteria you think is appropriate. In the medical services district, there's the use medical and dental clinics, and those are allowed by right. The definition that you see here is different, slightly different, and those differences are highlighted in red. This is a definition of an office, a dental or medical office. It's based, excuse me, exactly on the dental or medical clinic definition. But the caveat here is that this be by appointment only, that it's not a walk-in service, and that the appointments are limited to business hours. The suggestion, I think, was from Felicia, was that it would be 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. weekdays, Monday through Friday.
The only thing I might want to mention, there's some doctors sometimes are in the operating room all day, and once in a while they have evening hours by appointment. Not that they want to, but sometimes they don't have a choice. Sometimes these doctors with flus are so busy they open up their offices on Saturday morning, not as a rule, but by appointment, and very limited. So I think the appointment does the job and does what you guys want to do, and I'm happy with that. But to limit it Monday through Friday, I'd like to maybe expand that a little bit by appointment in the evening or Saturday mornings. Not that it's a big deal, but I hate to have it say, hey, you can't open up after 5 o'clock at night. I mean, I don't know if I'm out of line on that.
But right now we're at 7 to 7. It does say Monday through Friday. I would have no issue about striking Monday through Friday from that, because if they wanted to do 7 to 7 on a Saturday, I have no issue.
Usually,
the idea that it's not going to, you know, we don't want intensification of traffic or whatever later at night. So
Saturdays are usually till 1 o'clock or something. So I mean,
in the afternoon, right?
Yeah,
till 1. So Saturday 7 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I think even 7's a little early, but that's what you.
Well, they don't have to be open then. It's just
optional. That's fine. That works. That works good.
So we're going to continue this discussion to our meeting on November 23rd. Is that right? Everybody's got consensus on that?
Yes.
Okay.
The Barnstable Veterans Day Parade will leave at 10 a.m. from the Hyannis Village Green, proceed down South Street to Old Colony Boulevard, then up to Main Street and back to the Green. There will be a program featuring the Barnstable Middle School Band and the laying of wreaths to honor veterans of World War II, Korea, Vietnam, and the Persian Gulf. Now let's take a look at the meeting schedule for the remainder of the week. 7 o'clock, Old Kings Highway has a meeting on Route 149 in West Barnstable. There are no meetings for Wednesday, November 11th because of the Veterans Day holiday. For Thursday, November 12th at 9 o'clock in the morning, Site Plan Review has a meeting in the Town Hall Hearing Room. And on Friday, November 13th, there are no meetings. Thanks for joining us on this edition of Barnstable Today. I'm Kevin Friel.
And wearing a blazer just like Kevin, I'm Len Gobiel. Thank you.